Excuse me, I was just trying it on for size. Where was I now? Oh, yes. Ghosts aren't all that different from people, not really, you see. They like to be comfy and cozy, just like you and like me. They need a place to live and something to do. Haunting houses is their thing. Let's hope they never move in with you.
On a dark and rainy night, not long ago, Nancy LaBianca visited this West Side home to investigate what was thought to be a ghost.
When I get claim cases of the paranormal, I will go out and investigate. And in some circumstances, there are unseen activities. And I have been known to be able to cleanse the house of these and get rid of them.
Nancy is a parapsychologist, and for over 10 years, she has not only researched, but firmly believes she has communicated with the spirit world. 85% of her cases turn out not to be ghosts at all. For that reason, she will first search for any physical reasons for why a home may seem haunted, and then she'll screen her clients to be sure that they are mentally sound.
In this particular case, I saw that these were two intelligent, legitimate, concerned people that this was really bothering them, that didn't want to be bothered in this manner.
For the sake of their privacy, we'll call them Bob and Laura Smith. Their nightmare began when they realized their home was haunted by an entity that seemed to center in the bedroom. They had unsuccessfully sought the help of a priest, but reciting prayers and sprinkling holy water didn't change a thing. Whatever it was, though it was never seen or heard, could still be smelled.
The most distasteful smell you could ever imagine.
It just dropped down on us like a cloud.
It had an odor like urine and dried blood. It was a cadaver type odor when the body starts decomposing. It was that kind of an odor.
Sometimes it was in that area, in that corner. Then it would concentrate over here. It would bounce over here.
Nancy LaBianca's experience told her that what this house needed was to be cleansed.
And I could feel it was there.
So she held a seance in the bedroom, which she recorded on a cassette tape and infrared film. In these pictures, Nancy believes she has photographed the spirit that was haunting Bob and Laura, a spirit which at one point appears as if it totally surrounds Laura.
My skin was all clammy, and this odor was just hanging on me.
When the seance was over, the smell was gone. In the year and a half since, it has not returned. But what was it?
She had like a crack in the psychic egg, if you will, or an opening in the door wasn't closed for her. So these forces were coming down, and she could get the aroma of their presence. Whatever it was she did, the dear soul, she got rid of it.
I know there's ghosts, that's for sure.
This ghost story does not end here. On the tape recording of the seance, there appears to be a voice calling Nancy's name, a voice that she believes may be a spirit.
The Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Only one thing I am sure of is there is a voice on that tape.
But she brought that tape to my house, at the university, really, and asked me to listen to it.
Dr. Alan Canfield is a skeptical colleague of Nancy LaBianca's. Though he is open-minded to the spirit world, he thinks oftentimes people are too quick to call unexplained events ghosts.
Sure, a lot of people have a kind of a mindset. It's exciting to kind of the in thing to see a ghost, for one thing.
On the night that we shot the story about Nancy and her ghost-busting exploits, Dr. Canfield came along. Photographer Ed Riley and I recorded Nancy's spirit voice on videotape. When we returned to the station and played the videotape back, we heard more than we bargained for. An additional spirit voice, a high-pitched voice that sounded like it was right in the room. There were three specific spots on the tape where the voice could be heard, so we called Dr. Canfield and Nancy LaBianca and had them listen.
Is one of
almost the same quality, the same tone.
Their conclusions?
To me, I believe right now, my impressions about what is on that tape is the fact that there is a time-bound spirit.
You could have done that.
One of the doctor's theories is that the voice could be a Halloween hoax perpetrated by me.
Mike Randall, clever guy he is, could have brought that tape back with Ed, the cameraman who's so clever, and, countersunk those voices right into the voice stream.
We didn't fake the voice, folks. Scout's honor. Now, I don't know what it is we do have here on tape. I'm not saying it's a spirit voice, but I'm not saying it isn't either.
There's another haunted house not far away, one you can visit. But if I were you, I wouldn't stay.
The Mahoney Dollhouse Museum has a collection worth $1.5 million, but I'm not here to see dollhouses. I'm looking for ghosts. house is over 160 years old. It is said to have been used between 1825 and 1865 as part of the Underground Railroad, a safe house for slaves. In recent years, it has been the site of some peculiar and unexplained happenings, many of which have been witnessed by curator June Spear.
Nothing bad has ever happened. We've had some strange things, but nothing that's ever done anyone any harm.
According to June, footsteps have been heard, lights that were on have turned themselves off, and this dollhouse seems to have a life of its own. No matter where it's moved, witnesses swear it puts itself back in its favorite spot. Inside the dollhouse happens to be a miniature Ouija board. Last Halloween, June put a carved pumpkin out on the staircase. It mysteriously ended up on the floor. She replaced it with another one.
And that one was also knocked off. So we didn't put any more on the staircase after that.
Psychics have visited the house from time to time. One of them even pointed out a spot in the basement where supposedly a man was hanged. A place where, according to June, the light cord has been known to swing all by itself.
I still think there are presences in the house that maybe shouldn't be.
Only the spirits know for sure. And they're not talking. At least, not today.
When we return, we'll visit a haunted bookstore and one pink house with two terrifying tales.